Boy, with this one little addition to our gardens, we've really got a lot of mileage out of it. It's nothing more than a cattle panel that's mounted on some of the landscape timbers, and we've got a couple of them here to fit in at the end of one of our ground beds. And not only has it given us a lot of height in the garden, but it's given us a lot of opportunity to try some different things. Just in the past couple of years since I've been here, this trellis has been used to support some sunflowers, where we've used the sunflowers, the seeds, the actual head to make some wreaths out of, and we even use the sunflower stalks to stake some of our later crops. And the trellis helped us support the sunflowers. Then last year, if you were watching, you'll remember it was covered with the loofah sponge gourd, and we just had many numbers of the sponge gourds that we took off the vines there that we've used continuously this past year. And then this year we have something a little bit different. It's really considered a vegetable, but it is used primarily as an ornamental, and that's because of these beautiful pea or bean-like flowers, these purplish, pinkish color spikes that come out. And this is called a hyacinth bean, and it does produce a bean, which you can see here, that also has a purplish hull. The bean is actually grown primarily in the southern Asia continents and also Africa for the pod and the bean as an edible crop. But in the United States, again, it's used more for ornamental purposes. Now, I want to point out that when you look at the pod, normally it's anywhere from 3-4 inches in length. And the seeds will either be green, brown, or purple, so you'll get a little bit of variation. But they have this white scar here on the end of the bean that's very characteristic. So that's something that's very typical with the bean. And again, once they're mature, which this one needs to size up a little bit more, they are edible. You can use the pod or the beans themselves. But one thing I want to caution you about, even if you smell them when they're fresh like this, you'll see or smell a strong odor. That odor is also carried into when you cook them or prepare them indoors. So that's something that you'll want to be aware of. Also, when you look in the seed catalogs, we got this one from Park Seed Company, you'll notice a bush type hyacinth. And when you see that one, it's really not edible, only the vining one. And this one can get anywhere from 6 to 8 feet and very aggressive when we really don't have that many plants in here. So I would encourage most of you just to consider using it more for an ornamental in your garden. Now, the cattle panel that this bean is growing on is really just a panel that we use often in the garden, so we've kind of recycled it here for the height appearance in the garden. And recently, one of our 1992 video entries from Kansas had another great way of recycling farm equipment that we'd like to show to you right now.
This was the beginning of our collection. It's an old milk can. It has a curly leafed and a flat leaf mint in it. Behind it, you'll see a start of pampas grass and an old iron wheel. Then took a number of iron wheels and welded them together and made a trellis for the rose bushes. Plus several large shade trees in the backyard, the west side of our house, so this provides some shade for the back door. You will notice an old milk can and a bucket and an old pot. These make excellent planters. They have coleus in them. Also, you might notice a hanging basket with a Roma tomato planted in it upside down. Keeper gave me an old lawnmower. It's interesting to look at, but I'm glad we don't have to use it. We have a lot of morning glories. And this is our cactus bed with a large yucca and several cactuses in it. The morning glories are taking it over. Ben bought this old hay rake from a neighbor, and our daughter Melinda painted it last year for us and set it in the yard. It has a planter of morning glories sitting on it, but they're not doing near as well as the ones planted in the ground. This is a hay fork. It is hooked to a rope and a pulley on the outside of a barn to lift the hay into the loft. Planted in this hay are chicks and hens. This is a horse-drawn mowing machine. Corn planter. It has marigolds and lupins and vinca planted in it. Planter my husband uses to plant his sweet corn, so we just have pots of flowers sitting in it. Marigolds and salvia and rose moss. horse-drawn wheat drill. It has vinca and geraniums and begonias and dinner plate dahlias planted in it. That would be an excellent way to display the dahlias. They tend to have weak necks and look towards the ground. I did have to stake them up because they were out in the wind. I used old dried bamboo stalks. Turned out to be an excellent display, and we have several people who drive by and remember the old times when they used this type of equipment.